In this video, we will show you how to install the SmartShunt IP65. This new battery monitor is splash-proof and is ideal for locations like engine bays or in areas susceptible to dust or moisture. First, a short explanation of a SmartShunt. As it's important to monitor the state of charge of a battery bank, an accurate capacity metering is essential. A SmartShunt effectively measures the voltage and current in-out of the battery bank. With this data, the SmartShunt is able to calculate quite accurately what the state of charge percentage is. Reading out these values can be done on your smartphone using the VictronConnect app or by connecting to a GX device. So it's a far more accurate SoC monitoring than just looking at the battery voltage. This is what the SmartShunt looks like. This is the load minus. This is the battery minus. The black wire is the VE Direct socket to connect to a VE Direct cable or a VE Direct to USB interface. The red wire with fuse is to connect to the positive terminal of the battery. And the grey wire with fuse is the auxiliary cable. This can be used to monitor the voltage of a second battery or the midpoint of a battery bank. The auxiliary input can also be used for battery temperature monitoring, together with the optional temperature sensor for BMV. We will need the following tools to install the SmartShunt: a torque wrench, a screwdriver to mount the SmartShunt, a smartphone or tablet with VictronConnect, and the SmartShunt IP65. Mount the SmartShunt IP65 with the two mounting holes onto a solid surface. Now we will follow the steps from the manual. Connect the negative battery terminal to the M10 bolt on the battery minus side of the shunt. Tighten the shunt bolt with a maximum torque of 21 Newton meters. It's important that there should be no other connections on this side of the shunt or on the negative battery terminal. Any loads or charges connected here will be excluded from the battery state of charge calculation. Connect the negative of the electrical system to the M10 bolt on the load minus side of the shunt. Tighten the shunt bolt with a maximum torque of 21 Newton meters. Make sure that the negative of all DC loads, inverters, battery chargers, solar chargers, and other charge sources are connected after the shunt. Also, the minus of a starter battery needs to be on the load side. Connect the M10i terminal of the red cable with the fuse to the positive terminal of the battery. The battery monitor is now powered up and it's ready for configuration. If the system contains a GX device, such as a Servo GX, the battery monitor can be connected to the GX device using a VE Direct cable or a VE Direct to USB interface. Once connected, the GX device can be used to read out all monitored battery parameters. For more information, see Chapter Connecting to a GX Device and the VIM portal. The SmartShunt can be used for both battery monitoring and readout of DC power for a DC load or DC source. The VictronConnect app can be used to change all settings and to update the firmware. Open the VictronConnect app. Ensure that the battery monitor is powered on. The SmartShunt will show up in the local device list. You can search for the device using the serial code. Click on the SmartShunt. Enter the default PIN code, 6x0. Update the device. When successfully connected, the Bluetooth light stays on. To view and/or change battery monitor settings, such as the battery capacity and charged voltage, navigate to the settings page by clicking on the cog icon. One of the most important settings are the fully charged synchronization criteria. These ensure the SmartShunt to remain accurate over time. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. It doesn't cost you anything, and if you click the bell icon, you'll be notified about our next video.